Welcome to the fifth video in our TypeScript narrowing series. Be sure to watch the previous ones if you haven't yet. Their links are in the description. In this video, I'll show you assertion functions, also known as assertion guards. I'm Lucas Paganini, and in this channel, we release web development tutorials. Subscribe if you're interested in that. The reason why assertion functions are also known as assertion guards is because of their similarity to type guards. In our type guard for strings, we return true if the given argument is a string and false if it's not. If we wanted an assertion function instead of a type guard, instead of returning either true or false, our function would either return or throw. If it is a string, it returns. If it is not a string, it throws. If you call a function that throws if your value is not a string, then all the code that comes after it will only run if your value is a string. So, TypeScript narrows our type to string. To abstract this explanation, TypeScript uses control flow analysis to narrow our type to what was asserted. In this case, we have asserted that value is a string. We talk about control flow analysis in the second video of the series. I'll leave a link for it in the description. Now, when and why would you want to use an assertion function instead of a type guard? Well, the most popular use case for assertion functions is data validation. Suppose you have a Node.js server and you're writing a handler for user creation. The first thing you should do in your request handlers is validate the data. If any of the fields is missing or invalid, you will want to throw an error. When you have conditions to check at the beginning of your code and you refuse to run if those conditions are invalid, that's called an early exit, and it's the perfect scenario for assertion functions. If you want to know more about early exits, I have a 1-minute video explaining what they are. I'll leave a link for it in the description. Maybe you've noticed that I'm using function declarations instead of function expressions. There's a reason for that. By the way, knowing the differences between function declarations and function expressions is very important. I'm sure most of you already know that, but if you don't, it's okay. I made a 1-minute video explaining just that, and I'm leaving the link for it in the description. So, back to assertion functions. I'm using function declarations because TypeScript has trouble recognizing assertion functions during control flow analysis if they are written as function expressions. Function declarations work because they are hoisted, so their types are declared previously and TypeScript likes that. Personally, I think that's a bug and should be fixed, but I don't know if they're going to fix that. Currently, they say it's working as intended. To work around that issue, I found two alternatives. The first, using function declarations, and the second, use function expressions with predefined types. I prefer function expressions, so I'll go with the second option. For that, instead of defining our function signature along with its implementation, we will have to define its signature as an isolated type and cast our function to that type. Here's how it looks like if we wanted to use function expressions for our assertIsName function. And we were also using an assertHasProps function to check that our object has the properties that we expect. Maybe you're curious, so I'm just showing it to you because I think that function has an interesting signature. I'm also leaving a link to the GitHub issues and PRs related to this if you want to know more. Before we wrap this up, I want to show you a different signature for assertion functions. Weird, right? There is no type predicate, so what the hell are we asserting? This signature means that the condition to check is already a type guard. For example, you could give it a type of expression and it would narrow the type accordingly. Assertion functions are cool, right? People are just not used to them yet. References are in the description. If you enjoy the content, you know what to do. And if your company is looking for remote web developers, consider contacting me and my team on lucaspaganini.com. This is not the last video of this series. We have more to come. So until then, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.